I have been here in a center for transformation, healing base and medicinal plants and family and community. Very powerful, very beautiful times, very intense moments the last month and a half here. And I'm recording this video because I wanted to share some of the teachings I have been receiving from the people here and mainly from the healer Pepe, who is an outstanding man who is running the center. And basically, when we talk about anything, the same answer comes every single time, right? People ask him about how to live life, where is happiness, how to heal our old wounds from our childhood, how to improve our relationships with our mothers, with our parents, with our partners, right? How to deal with that specific illness, that specific symptom in your physical body that doesn't allow you to live fully, how you can express yourself and basically how to live a life with integrity, wholeness, with joy. And I wanted to share that answer that comes every single time, because I think it's very powerful and I think can help you a lot. It's helping me a lot to deal with the adversity of life. It's something that we cannot deny, right? Sometimes life hit us very strong in a very unexpected ways, and this is something that I personally believe that we cannot control. I mean, the only thing that we can really control is the way that you react, your inner space, your inner environment, right? But in this external environment, let's say, we need to be open of whatever. So, how to live life with wholeness, integrity, happiness, how to deal with the adversity. This kind of formula or system come up in every single time, and everything start with, as this main healer here Pepe share, with acceptance. And acceptance, I have been reading about it, I have been feeling about it, but I never understood it really completely, which is the first step of this whole system. Acceptance is the main part of the process, right? You can perceive in your life that whatever you are resisting will persist. So let's say, please don't think now in a pink elephant. Don't think now in a pink elephant. Now you're thinking in a pink elephant. Whatever your mind trying to resist, it will attract it even more. So acceptance is the key. Acceptance is the key for healing and transformation, and to understand and move forward in your path, right? I guess it's the most important step on this process. Why is so important? Because when you accept completely what's going on, you loosen up. You loosen up. You relax. You automatically release. And that sense of relaxation give you the space, the right space for move forward, for transform, and for using tools, right? For deal with that specific thing, even if it's a person, or it's a symptom, or it's an emotion, or whatever, or it's an experience. And it's a very interesting concept, because if you think about it, there's no, as Pepe say with this word, there's no conflict that have finished completely after a fight or after a war. There's no conflict that have been finished 100% done, close with love, after a fight. And the conflict, like the war that you are living inside, will still be there until you accept. And not only that, right? Also, as Buddhists, when Buddhists meditate in Vipassana, they meditate on the anicca, on the impermanence. They accept the fact that this shall to pass, that this is going to finish. Whatever you're thinking in your mind, whatever conflict, whatever person, even your life, is going to have an end sooner or later. So understanding and accepting impermanence also is a great tool to start moving forward, right? In whatever you are dealing with, in whatever you are dealing with your partners or with your inner emotion or what specific illness or symptom in your body, close your eyes and observe it and fully accept what's going on. I think that's the key at the beginning. Then when you move forward to the second step of three, is all right, what tools I have like this position to me from the cosmos that I can deal with this situation. And that tools could be whatever, could be meditation, could be EFT, could be psychology, could be stoicism, could be philosophy, could be vipassana, could be your physical body, could be your speech, could be your smile, right? So if you have this person in front of you who you're not getting along with, that could be an emotion as well, it could be a body symptom as well. After acceptance, all right, this is what's going on. I fully accept. I will not fight against it. And watch your language, huh? Watch your language when you say, oh, I hate because my knees are pain. I hate this guy. I don't like this guy. You're resisting. You're not even in the first step. When you move forward for finding what tools, it needs to come from acceptance. And that tool could be a smile, could be what you learned in your last self-help book, could be Reiki, could be anything. But things that you have around, things you know already, things you took trainings about it. So it's the same principle that in Tantra they talk about the Dharma, right? How to live your Dharma, what tools you have, you live your Dharma. They talk about the Artha. So you use the Artha to live in your Dharma. So they embrace the fact that you have a bunch of tools available in your life that you can deal with, and that's our gifts. I mean, you cannot say like, all right, I am accept, but I don't know how to deal with. I mean, studying that you have a physical body and a human brain that make you think. You have a bunch of books, you have a bunch of trainings, you have advice from your friends or from your teachers. So finding that tool, it will help you so much to deal with that. And this Pepe, that he call it sacred living. And why he call it sacred living or sacred life? Because when you do this, when you use this tool to deal with this adversity, let's say, you do it in a sacred way, right? You do it with a sacred way, accepting the fact that this event that is going on is a gift, is an opportunity to grow, is an opportunity to transform. Otherwise, how are you going to transform? How are you going to self-realize? How to find that? How are you going to graduate from life if you don't have the hardcore test? So you have been gifted. So stop being the victim first, right? So stop being the victim is basically accepting what's going on, that you are in this school, and then you have this tool to deal with, and you do it in this inner joy of knowing that this is helping you. This is helping you to understand. And Pepe say with this word, if somebody is bothering you, look at him with sacred eyes, listen to him with sacred ears, observe him with love, and you right away, you will heal him and heal yourself. Sacred life is the step number two. And the step number three, in order to finish, in Spanish we call it entrega. Entrega, which is, could be translated as surrender, or could be translated as like giving yourself. And this is how you close it. And what surrender, giving yourself means to trust. To trust that tool that you just use to to deal with this that you just accept is the right thing that you should be doing in that moment. If you don't trust, basically it's not going to work, right? So you trust 100%, and even if the expected outcome doesn't happen, you keep trusting that it's something else that you don't know consciously yet, that it's helping you to transform and understand, right? So life works in a very mystical way, right? We know some stuff consciously with this part of the brain, but there's so much, guys, going on there that we are not even aware. If you're living life through your five senses, probably we are missing a lot. And this part of surrendering and giving yourself is all about, as I say, trust. And it's all about closing this with love, right? Closing this with love, closing this process of dealing with this adversity with, all right, I'm done with this. I did whatever. I took my tool that I have in my hands, and then I surrender. In Tantra, sometimes they call it consecration, right? The consecration of a deity, of a god, of consciousness, of whatever. So basically, you, in Spanish we call it encomendarse. You give yourself and trust, and you can use this divine thing that you may, you can use consciousness, you can use God, you can use Shiva, the Buddhahood, whatever, right? You consecrate and you leave it in the hands of the divine, of God. If for you the divine of God is too winky, you can surrender this and give it in the hands to your higher self, which is yourself. Without all the bullshit, basically, without all the conditioning, without all the patterns, without everything that blur your mind to see with clarity. So basically, accept living life, sacred life, and trust and surrender and giving yourself all these three steps that there's not something new. I talk to Pepe, I say, Pepe, have been reading this and learning this in different words, in Buddhism, in Tantra, in yoga philosophy, in Taoism, in different ways, and actually what he say, the knowledge is universal. This is not something that begins here, right? The knowledge is universal. Everyone knows already. Everyone knows what is the way. There are different ways to express it, a different ancient tradition with enlightened beings who realize all of that, and they put it in words. They wrote the Vedas. They wrote, I don't know, an ancient text of knowledge, and there were people here around us, as you know, some that were sharing this concept, maybe in different ways, but this is the way I believe that we should engage with life, fully trusting, fully accepting first what's going on, using the tools, right? You have your body, you have your hands. Acceptance is not about conformism, by the way. Acceptance is an active position. It's an active position, it's a very solid position that prepares you to act. You act, you do stuff, you use the tools that you have, you use these hands, you use this, and then you fully trust and surrender of whatever.